country, committed to Duke over the weekend. John Calipari was asked about not landing him at Kentucky. Say what?
We don't get every kid. I've said that all along. We get the ones that need to come here. Others choose not to, and that's fine. That's their choice. Obviously, the kids that have come here are worth over $1 billion.
He ain't lying.
He's not lying.
That's my dude there.
Don't like it. Don't read between the lines. Just read.
Yeah, and their families, because that's one thing that Coach Cal is into. It's not only the development of that player, but he's really into the institution of that family. How I can take that family economically. Now, it's more important to him than even winning championships, because he compromises by letting the guys leave and encouraging them to take advantage of the NBA and that first-round lottery money.
Not only encouraging guys to leave, having guys play a position that they're going to play in the NBA that might not be what's best suited for them to be playing as a freshman at Kentucky. We've seen guys that in the NBA are going to be stretch fours. He lets play stretch four while in Kentucky when other coaches would be more likely to have them down on the block. He's been, his total honesty about part of my deal is I'm getting paid a ton of money.
Yes.
Part of my deal is I'm going to help you and your family create generational wealth as quickly as possible.
And everything. Coach Cal is very, very upfront. This is the program that I'm going to run, and he's done very, very well and been successful for the family.
Just the five guys in that picture, by the way, if we talk about active contract and money already earned, if I'm doing quick math in my head, you're at almost $740 million, just those five guys. It's unbelievable what they've been able to do. Unbelievable.
They all like leggings. Hey, time for some stories to start your morning. The Milwaukee Bucks announced yesterday they fired head coach Jason Kidd. I'm always good for that line.
Yeah, Richard Simmons. Leggings went out with him.
Well, apparently not. Jay Kidd went 139 and 152 in four seasons as the Bucks coach. Nick, what do you think? Right move getting rid of Jason Kidd?
Absolutely right move. Typically, you'd say, if our superstar loves him, do we want to get rid of him? Steph loved Mark Jackson. It was the right move to get rid of Mark Jackson. Jason Kidd, some of his in-game absurdity, whether it's telling his own player to miss a free throw that would have put them up four, or having his
That's not as good as a bump into me so I can spill something on the
floor. Hey, Chalmers, come here.
Oh, no, look what happened.
It's unbelievable. I mean, he's not a good basketball coach. And CC, you've talked about sometimes the best players, it's hard for them to coach. They can't explain what they can see. Yeah. He hasn't been good at it. The Bucks will be better off without him.
But the NBA is not short on opportunities for former players. Now, you have a long career in the NBA, man, they will give you a job. Jason Kidd, I believe they finally found him out. The X's and O's, like, he can't hide them. He's not great at the X's and O's. He was a great player, but just like Phil Jackson was great on the sideline, when you put him up to the general manager, a lot of times it doesn't transfer, and I don't see that with Jay Kidd.
All right. Interesting news out of San Antonio. Reports are Kawhi Leonard and the Spurs are at odds over his rehab. Kawhi has only played 9 games this season as he recovers from a right quad injury. Cece, what was your reaction to the possible tension between these two sides?
I'm not surprised at all. Kawhi is a little bit different. He's not a high-maintenance superstar that we're used to having, but Kawhi, I would say that him and his management, I might know, I might have a source that might know one or two things about it. Yes, they're not happy with the overall situation, and this injury did not help their situation because it's unbeknownst to them that he would be missing this amount of time. So did he get misdiagnosed, which also has Kawhi in his camp upset at San Antonio?
Well, so for you not to be surprised, you've got to have some inside information because based on
maybe.
Because based on history, this is shocking. You never hear this type of stuff coming out of San Antonio. Just like you never hear someone demanding a trade as LaMarcus Aldridge.
Yeah, how shocked were we when we heard about Tom Brady getting Garoppolo out? Sometimes even the powerhouses, there's stuff that goes on in the family. They don't let the family business hit the street.
This is two separate instances now with unrelated players for San Antonio. The Aldridge one they handled, and they're all better for it. Well, yet to be seen what happens with Kawhi Leonard. I'm telling you guys, my Kawhi Leonard for Anthony Davis fake trade from 3 months ago looks all the better day by day.
I was just thinking, what happened to that fake
change? It works. Who says no? Who says no?
Fiery moment between Saleh Mesri and his coach Rick Carlisle last night. Mesri was jarring with refs after getting ejected, and Carlisle had about enough of it. He was caught on camera yelling, "Hey, you got two bleeping points. Get the bleep out of here." CC, what was your reaction?
Oh, this is Rick Carlisle. I love it. I love the part two when he got on Rondo, when he called the timeout, tried to call timeout. Rondo waved him off. He was like, "No, give me a timeout. Get off the dang on court." I love coaches who coach that way. I've always been coached that way, and the coach has been most effective. Just completely honest and frank with you. I like Rick Carlisle. He's a very good coach. They don't have the talent in Dallas, but he'll be competing for a championship in the next several years.
If we're ranking NBA coaches, Pop's number one. Carlisle's in that next tier, that discussion, along with Brad
Stevens. I prefer to have him above Brad Stevens.
I know you.
Because he's proved it. Stevens. I mean, what has Brad proven?
I think Brad Stevens
nothing.
Is...
Okay, but go ahead.
I disagree with you that he's proven nothing. That's either here or there. The point is, because the Mavs haven't been good in the last 4 years, people have forgotten what a great coach Rick Carlisle is. And this is a funny moment. I do like Houston's own Kelly Oubre saying, "Get out of here. Goodbye." Saleh, I like that. I like the whole scene right there.
All right, what a night for Boogie Cousins last night. 44 points, 24 rebounds, 10 assists in a double overtime win over Chicago. The first 40-20, 10 games since, Nick.
Scream!
So, Nick, how impressed were you with Boogie's night?
It was great. I mean, there are... He and his teammate are the only two players in the league that could do this. Maybe Russell, but I don't think Russell's going to... It's tough for Russell to get 20 rebounds. The Westbrook I'm talking about.
Yes.
A 40-20-10 game is unreal. If you watch this game, they were down 17 midway through the fourth. Anthony Davis fouls out, and Boogie just put them on their shoulders. A lot of people, myself included, that were curious, how would Boogie and AD coexist? Thus far, they've coexisted quite well. Need a little better guard play in New Orleans.
Whatever happened to the Boogie and LeBron trying to come together? Because that was rumors for a while. Wow. Boogie's in the last year of his contract.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, are they going to move him? Are they going to re-up? I'm very happy for Boogie. I told you before, very close with Coach Cal. This is one of his kids and everything. He struggled a little bit off the court with some emotional things. He is a big-time talent. He's the most skilled big man that we've seen in the NBA in a long time. And it's nice and refreshing to see in this three-point shooting NBA that we see now, a big man with skill inside and outside. He's an amazing basketball player.
And to answer your question, what happened to him maybe being traded? New Orleans been too good. New Orleans says, we're going to go ahead and try to make the playoffs and do some
him
damage.
Him and LeBrow have worked together.
They worked together.
That's what kind of negated that trade.
Absolutely.
We'll get to the Brow. And finally, lost in the shuffle over the weekend, classic case of he said, he said. The Rockets beat the Warriors 116-108. After the game, Rockets center Clint Capella said Houston is better than the Warriors. And also he said that he likes his Art Project better than my Art Project. That's crazy. Kevin Durant responded to Capella's comments yesterday. Take a listen to this.
You hear that from the guys like Capella, you know, usually he's catching the ball and laying it up from CP or James Harden. So his job is not as hard. I mean, when your job is that hard, you know you can't just come out there and say like that. You know what I'm saying? So I don't expect that from CP and James and Reza and the rest of the guys because they know how hard it is to come out there and do that every night. Capella, I mean, catch a dunk every night, so it's pretty easy for him.
Little insight here. We have a meeting at 4 a.m. and we go through a number of topics to see what's going to make it into the show. And Nick went like this, quiet. Kevin Durant? Let me tell you what I think about Kevin Durant.
He's the world's foremost expert on what he's talking about.
And here you go.
So I'm glad he's talking about it.
Yeah.
There's no one in the world, certainly in the athletic world, better positioned to have an opinion about things you will say when your job gets easier that you wouldn't say when your job was harder. Like, Kevin Durant, the guy that joined a 73-win team, and prior to that, we never saw this side of his personality. Now, all of a sudden, that his job's easier, that a lot of the pressure's been removed from him, things he's talking about Capella, now we hear all types of things from Kevin Durant that we never heard before. So whether he's right or wrong, whether he should be mad that the Rockets would dare think they can compete with the Warriors. Kevin Durant, no one is better. It is like me talking about people with big noses on television. I am the world's foremost expert in the field. Kevin Durant is the world's foremost expert in, when your job gets easier, you talk a little crazier. So I'm glad we got to hear this from KD.
All the superstars that have decided to partner with other players, all their jobs got easier. All right? You saying Kevin Durant's job got easier when he left OKC and went to Golden State. You know who else's job got easier? Steph Curry's job got easier. Draymond's job got easier. Klay's job got easier. When LeBron, when he got smacked by San Antonio in Cleveland, and then he decides to leave after that and go to Miami, you know whose job got easier also? LeBron James's job got easier. So I understand the distinction he's making with Capella, because Golden State doesn't have a center. So his job is easier, not only by assignment, but who he would be guarding. He don't have to guard Klay. He don't have to guard Draymond. He don't have to guard Steph. So I understand what he was saying. I don't mind Kevin Durant talking. Nick, you seem to like all the other guys talking. Why can't Kevin Durant talk?
Of course he.
And it's the truth. Capella's job is a lot easier, and the guys like Harden and CP3 and Ariza, you won't see them saying that, because they know this is a difficult task, and even if they thought it, they know better than to say it.
Harden came close saying it. He didn't quite say we're better. He said this is the best we've ever felt. This is the closest we've been to a
championship. That's what you're supposed to say.
Okay, so you're bringing up other guys' jobs getting easier.
Well, you made the point that Kevin Durant's job got easier, so I thought that it's a perfect thing to maybe, let's look at the other NBA players whose jobs got easier,
right,
too.
It would be a perfect thing if we then had an example of, after LeBron's job got easier, him going after the seemingly anonymous center of the, if he had gone after Chris Mim, if he had decided, you know what, Keith Kloss, I am coming for you. Like, that's not.
So you would have felt better if he said this about Harden. If he had said about Harden or something, you'd be okay with it.
I guess it wouldn't have made sense, the context of the comments about Harden, because
him out of a lineup.
CeCe, but the question was about Capella saying the Rockets are better than the Warriors. It had nothing to do with about difficulty of job or importance to your team.
He was actually explaining why Capella could come to that opinion. Yes, I could understand a guy who's a role player. We don't have a center. Yeah, I could see his job's a lot easier. To me, it's very logical.
Okay, well, we're not seeing the same logic tree there, because when one guy says our team can beat that team, and Kevin Durant's logic,
he's not a star.
That's fine.
Capella, how long has Capella been in the league?
4 years.
What? Have we ever had him on any type of show? No. Have he ever been quoted?
CeCe, what on earth does that do with the discussion?
The reason why, Nick, is because the guy's being quoted. That's what it's got to do with the discussion.
Okay.
The only reason why is because he said they were better than Golden State.
Correct.
They talked to one of the Golden State players.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm shocked one of the Golden State players said something back.
Okay, that's CeCe. But he's asked, the question that's being asked is about Rockets. Rocket center Clint Capella says they're better than you. How you draw the line to his job's easy.
I wasn't getting ready to say anything.
How you draw the line between his job's easy because he catches alley-oops, I don't see it. And one thing, if we're going to talk about jobs easier and importance to the team, one thing that I believe, and I think I would imagine most people do, the Rockets can win the title this year. They're underdogs, so they can win it. If Clint Capella goes down for a season-ending injury, they no longer can win the title. If Kevin Durant right now was lost for a season-ending injury, the Warriors absolutely could still win the title.
No, they wouldn't. They wouldn't. They wouldn't have a chance.
They wouldn't have a chance?
They wouldn't have a chance because they don't have a rim protector, and they would miss his scoring.
See?
And when you get Durant, you also lose your bench. So if they lose any one of those four players, they are going to lose in the playoffs.
CeCe, we saw them last year play 20 games without him and play as well as they did with him.
We got to break this up.
Without that bench, with the same situation.
I'm just going to recap. He said, we're better than he is, and he said, I don't like him.
Yeah,
so
get a Twitter account. Tweet him, man.
8 minutes DM. Later. 8 minutes later, here we are. Coming up, is it time for the Cavaliers to blow up the roster? Let's jack this back up. Next on First Things First.
Yeah, we got Capella on the show.
I don't like that guy.
In Chile Nation, we love our football.